Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we will cover DD statement. So this is the agenda. We'll see what is DD statement, and then we'll see the syntax of DD statement followed by positional parameters and keyword parameters. So what is a DD statement? DD means data definition. DD statement is used to define data sets, whether it's an input data set or whether it's an output data set. And this is the syntax. Here you need to mention the DD name. You can use any name here. Then this is the keyword DD, then we have positional parameters and keyword parameters. Now we'll discuss positional parameters. We have three positional parameters. One is asterisk, then data, then dummy. So if we have chosen asterisk, that means all the data, all the output messages or whatever there is in the file, it will be printed to the spool. Here spool is our output. And then we have data. Suppose if you want to put the data in, like you want to give any data, then you need to give sysin.dd data and you can pass data to COBOL modules. Then we have dummy. So it's a dummy data set. Nowhere data will be printed. It's just for giving, like if it's a mandatory thing for any procs, IBM utilities, there we mention as dummy because we do not want to give any data set. Then we have keyword parameters, DCB, DISP, DSN. So we'll first start with DCB. So in DCB, we used to mention the record length, record size, and what should be the record format. So all these things are mentioned in the DCB parameters. Then we have DISP. Disposition is like in which mode you want to open this. If it's an input file and you want to open it in input mode, then it's a share. Then you need to mention DISP is equal to share. And if you want to create a new file, then disposition will be new. So this thing we'll cover in the hands-on part. Then we have DSN. DSN means data set name. Here you need to give the name of data set which you want to use. Either it can be input and output. Then we have sysout, like where your system messages should be printed. It can be a data set or it can be asterisk. Like here you have seen, if you have mentioned sysout asterisk, then everything will be printed to the spool. Then we have delimiter. So what is a delimiter? When we are passing data to a COBOL module using a GCL, then the default delimiter is slash and then asterisk, and you want to change this delimiter. Delimiter means it's end of data. When system encounters this slash after that asterisk, it seems like the data is over. So we can change this option using delimiter. So we can give DLM is equal to $. So at that time, the delimiter will become $. Similarly, we have unit and volume. They are for like where we are storing it and on which volume we are storing all these data sets. So now let's see all these functions practically. We will see the use of DD statements for defining data sets. In this member, I have coded one DD statement for input, output, and for positional parameters. Reset. We will start with positional parameters. We have three positional parameters. One is DD star. Here you need to mention the name, then DD star. This is used to pass data to the program. Like I am passing in stream data to the module program 1. Similarly, we have sysin.dd data. This is similar to DD star only. Here also we will pass the data to program 1. Then we have DD dummy. This is a dummy data set. Suppose if you do not want to mention any data set, you can mention DD dummy. So now we'll start with the keyword parameters. Here you need to mention the name, then you need to mention the DD, this is the keyword, then DSN, dataset name. Here you need to mention the dataset name and then the disposition. If we want to mention a file in input mode, program 1 is using an input file. So it will be opening this file input in share mode. This is disposition. Like how the program will be accessing our file. Similarly, program will be creating an output. This is the output file.
Till here, syntax is same. You need to give the name, then DD the keyword. Dataset name is tutorial.point.output. You can choose any name. So output of program 1, PGM 1, will be stored in this dataset. These are the keyword parameters. We'll start with disp. This is disposition. Here you need to mention status, normal disposition and abnormal disposition. Status can be new, old, share, mode. If the file does not exist and if you want to create it, then you need to mention new. Suppose a file is already there and you want to replace its data, then you need to mention old. If you mention old and suppose some data is present in the file, then the existing data will be deleted and the new data will be added. Then we have share. This is used to open PDF in share mode or a file in share mode. Then we have mode. Suppose you have a file, the file is existing one, and you do not want the data to be deleted, the existing data, then you need to mention mode. So in this, the data will be appended at the end. Next we have normal disposition. In normal disposition, it means suppose the file, the program and the step, it is terminated normally, or it is completed normally and it is terminated abnormally. So we have mentioned two steps. First is status, then the normal disposition in the normal scenario, and if it terminates abnormally, then these factors will come into picture. For normal disposition, we have these values. It can be catalog, keep, uncatalog, delete and pass. If we mention catalog, in this scenario, the data set is retained and a catalog entry is made. Then we have keep. So in this, only the data set is retained. Then we have uncatalog. So the data set is retained, but its catalog entry is removed. We have delete. In this scenario, the data set will be deleted. Suppose if it terminates, if it completes normally, not a minute, if it completes normally, then the data set will be deleted. Then we have pass. This is used for temporary data sets. Similarly, for abnormal disposition, we have catalog. The functions are same. In this, the data set is retained and a catalog entry is made. Then we have keep. The data set is retained. Then we have uncatalog. The catalog entry is removed. And then we have delete. If the jobs terminate abnormally, we give delete. It means delete the data set. Then we have DCB. So it describes the physical characteristics of a data set. Like what should be the record length, the record format, block size, and the organization. In mainframe overview videos, we have created a PS and a PDS. There we have mentioned these parameters, like what should be the record length, the record format, the block size, and the organization. So here we have mentioned record length is 80. Format can be fixed block or variable block. This should be a multiple of record length. And the organization is PS. It can be PS, PDS. Then we have space parameters. So this is for PS and this is for PDS. In mainframe's overview, I have told you if the directory blocks is 0, then it's a PS. And if we have some value in the directory block, then it's a PDS. So this is the directory block, 5. So this is a PDS. In above line, we haven't mentioned directory blocks, so it will create a PS file. Then we have unit. It is used to specify the system to allocate the dataset on a specific device. Here we need to give the device number. You can get this from your organization. Then we have volume. Here you need to mention the serial number of the volume. This is all about DD statements. In the next video, we'll start with in-stream procedures.